Welcome back everyone to another projects demo, and in this one we'll talk about the RB3 robotic arm. Now this is a project that I've been working on for quite a while, and I now have a fair enough functional demo that I can show you guys. The robotic arm is powered by the Qualcomm RB3 development board, which is based on the Qualcomm Snapdragon 845. Again, this is a very, very powerful CPU with an even more powerful GPU on it. It's ideal for OpenCV, image recognition, AI, and all that kind of stuff. It also has a bunch more I/O, like a lot more than your standard 96 boards configuration, so that you can actually attach a lot of motors, servos, and stuff like that. So again, I will leave a link in the description, so go ahead and check that out as well. So actually, let's just go to the main screen and see what it's all about. So here we have a bunch of things running. On the screen you can see the actual arm on the top and the view from the camera on board the robotic arm, so which would be that one on the bottom. And on the side you have the output from the actual script. So right now only the shape.py script is running, which is basically used to detect the shape, and we are going to run the main Python script, and that will show us how everything works. So the objective is we send a command to the robot, or we actually speak something and the robot understands what we want and carries out the action. So let's see how it all works. I will guide through some of the things that's happening. As soon as I start the main.py script, it will set up the audio stuff and wait for my input, and from that point onwards things should be a bit more self-explanatory. So hey July, pick up the blue rectangle. So as you can see, the robotic arm has tried to center the rectangle at the center of the screen, and now it's just going in for the grab. And once it clamps it, it will pick it up, and in a few moments it will drop it and then reset to its original position, thereby recognizing my voice and then executing the command that I said. Now all that I say right now will be printed on the screen because it's already listening for any sort of trigger commands, which in this case is actually hey July, since the project was started sometime in that month. So let's go once more. I'll actually wait for the voice input prompt to kind of reset. Hey July, pick up the yellow rectangle. So once again the arm starts to move, centers the yellow rectangle on the screen, and then goes in for the grab. When it goes in for the grab, it will move its arms a bit backwards just to make sure that it's on the center of the object, or actually nearby to properly grab the object itself. And once it's done, it then goes up and throws it, which is actually a motion where it resets itself, and then kind of just drops the object, and depending upon where it is, it will actually throw it. So let's bring another object in focus of the lens, and once again we can go hey July, pick up the red rectangle. And as you can see, the motion repeats itself. It will center the object and then go in for the grab. And there you have it, a pick and throw robot, all running OpenCV for the detection. The way the servos are controlled is through a feedback loop. There's no PID as such involved. Whatever the robot sees, it updates every second, and just sends that feedback to the motor and asks it to turn 1 degree at a time, and that's how I kind of control the speed as well as the position of the motor. In other setups, you might have a pre-laid out XY matrix or XY position system for the motors itself. Here, whatever the motor sees, it's very relative to what's on the lens. So it has to be a feedback loop from the camera that's on board, which basically means you can place the object anywhere as long as it's in the frame of the camera. All right, thank you so much for watching that small demo, and I hope you all enjoyed it. I will link the blog post in the description so you guys can go and check it out. It's still under work, so there are a few bits and pieces missing here, but the code for most of it should work, and you can try it out on your own hardware. I am using a PCA 9685 PWM controller to control the servos over I2C, and so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all with an update on this project on the 96 Boats channel. As always, don't forget to subscribe and meet us weekly for open hours on Thursday. We also have some other weekly or bi-weekly calls on live streamed on YouTube that you can also watch. I'll link everything down in the description. Till that time, thank you so much for watching.